was there.
Man, I ain't seen this something that lasts a long time.
Hey, I'm beating him on just that.
Dude, I'm still tripping off all three of them James here. Dude, I ain't seen you do that stuff since.
Never, he ain't never shot that bitch, man. MJ can't shoot, we know that. Come on, man. He ain't never been no shooting. No, he ain't play, bro.
Come on, all I'm saying now. Dude, you was in beast mode today, man.
You more like what he's gotten into.
Really, Bobby?
Oh.
Really?
What y'all talking about?
My fault.
Man, we ain't talking about it.
I'm just playing.
Come on.
I'm
doing the thing.
I'm just playing. Hey, by
the line. Nah, come on, dude.
Somebody mess up. Now, who is she?
She? She? Why you gotta automatically assume he referring to a woman? Mm. Come on, man. Look, now listen, Bobby. Yeah. You know that I'm married.
Yeah.
Look, MJ, you know I'm married. All you guys have seen my wife. She is fine.
Yes.
Look at this house I'm in, dude. Come on. Y'all see where I stay. Why would I do anything to mess that up? Come on, man. Get out of here with that mess, man. You know me better than that, MJ.
See, you can run that fast talking game on somebody who don't know, but I know.
Alright.
And we go way
back. Exactly. We go way back.
You my boy and all, man. I know you got a history of skipping out on me, man.
Oh, come on.
You know you do. Not to mention the fact, I'm telling you, man, you can act shade all you want to. You keep hurting that girl, you won't go end up on the short end. Dude, what I'm trying to tell you
is
you got a good woman.
You do, you do.
Most men wish they had a woman like her. You keep taking advantage of her. Not to mention, you up every week preaching and teaching on marriage and family, but just for the mere fact you got a good woman in there, that should be enough reason to do right by her.
Yeah. Maybe I'm tripping. I might be tripping. I don't know, but MJ, it kind of sounds like you feeling my wife, dude. Like, wait, hold on, Bob. Listen, I know you just heard MJ say it, right?
Yeah, I heard it.
Is it just me, or does it sound like MJ feeling my wife, man? Like, MJ, you feeling my wife, bro? Like, are you trying to smash me, man? Is that what we're talking about? Is that what we on, man?
Come on, man. Life's too short. See, when you love and you live alongside her, you start to see things different.
Alright.
Now, I ain't asked for me, but I tell you what, if I ever had the opportunity, she'll know what a real man is.
Man, you need to get out of my house.
Yeah, I'm going. But you know what I say.
Man, nobody care what you say. Get out of my house.
That's deep right
there. Man, you believe this dude, man? How you got the nerve, the audacity, to come up into my crib and talk to me like that? Man, I'm the king in this house. What did that right?
I'm just saying. I get what he's saying, and I ain't judging you, but I am saying, if you want to be with somebody else, at least let me be home so she can move on with her life. That's all I'm saying. That's it. Just be straight up with her.
All right.
That's all I'm saying.
All right, man.
All right. Taking a nice seat with this couch.
All right. We good. Thank you for coming at me the right way.
I'm always your man.
All right, dude. That's cool. I mean, that makes sense, man. I mean, that's why I'm probably going to go ahead and give me these divorce papers today, man. Yeah, man, come on, man.
Oh my.
You at church with me every week.
Yeah.
When's the last time you seen Mimi at the church? Dude, Mimi is so busy with the house and taking care of her job and all that stuff. She ain't got time for me no more, bro. She ain't got time for me no more, man. Now look, Kizzy, on the other hand, she getting impatient. And I think it's just time for me and Mimi to split so I can go on and get that support system that I need. You know what I'm saying?
Me. I just didn't hear what I thought I heard. You gonna leave Mimi for Kizzy?
What's wrong with Kizzy? Wow. Kizzy is a great woman, dude. She is
okay.
She's absolutely perfect with the church stuff. She takes care of the building fund.
Yes.
She be on the commercial board.
Yes.
You seen the new light bulbs and the new door handles we have?
Yes.
That was Kizzy. That was Kizzy. Kizzy be doing that, man. That's what I'm talking about, man.
But maybe you should ask her. I'm just saying.
Bobby.
You know an elevator don't move enough. Flow.
Come on. Man, you don't know Kizzy the way I know Kizzy. Man, Kizzy is a great woman, man.
Yes, she
lets me be simple. She lets me be me. She lets me be in charge. You know what I'm saying?
She
gives me the support I need. It's almost like me and Kizzy were made for each other, man.
You know what? As crazy as it might seem, the way you treat Mimi, you and Kizzy might be made for each other.
You know what?
So you know what? I'm going to pray for you. Because it's going to be a sad day when Big K get all day.
Big K?
Yeah,
you
Big
talking
K.
about
Kmart? No, Kmart. No, I'm talking about Karma. She's for me.
All right, man, listen. Enough with all that, man. Look, I need you to help me out because I got to figure out what I need to do in order to tell Mimi.
I got you, but I don't know about trying to help you do all that right now.
Come on, man. I just need them to figure out what I need to tell her. Because I don't know how to break it down. Maybe I should wait until dinner. Maybe I should do it. What's wrong, bud?
Well, you know, I saw Bobby's car out front, and I figured y'all were just hanging out, and I didn't want to disturb you.
So I guess that means you heard, huh?
Heard what, Jeremy?
Come on. Let me talk to you for a second. Sit down. Listen. Mimi, baby. You are a beautiful woman. You are intelligent. You have a great job. You have so much going for you. But I think it might be time that we go our separate ways. Look, see, I'm looking for someone who could be in church with me and do the ministry with me. You know? Right now you're so busy with your job and taking care of the house and everything that you don't have time for me no more, man. I need to be in church and look out and see my girl in the church looking back at me. Man, I think you're just too busy to give me the support that I need. Don't get me wrong, you know what I'm saying? I don't want anything financial, you know what I'm saying? You can keep the house, you keep your car and everything like that. That's fine, but I think it's time that I get out of this marriage so I can move on with my life.
If that's what you want, Jeremy, then so be it.
Wait, what? Hold on. That's it? You ain't got nothing else to say?
I mean, what do you expect for me to do, Jeremy? Yes, that's it. See, one of the things I've learned while you were out doing your ministry work is that at some point, you just gotta let go. Now I'm tired, and I'm about to go in the back and lie down. And I hope that when I get up, I hope you're gone, okay? Goodbye, Jeremy.
must be going on between her and MJ. That just ain't, that did not go how I expected. Yo, De'Asia, what's up?
Hey.
Hey, this is Jeremy. Listen, I need to ask you a quick question. I'm trying to figure out if something's going on between her and MJ.
Seriously?
Yes, listen. Okay, so I'm sitting here and I'm talking to Mimi, and I'm telling her how things are going, and then, you know, I told her I wanted a divorce, and I handed her some divorce papers. And then she just got up and walked away like everything was cool. Like she was waiting on that. And I'm just trying to figure out what's going on. Hello? Hello? Yeah? Oh, so everybody wanna play games with me today. Alright. Alright, we're gonna find out today, I promise you that.
Preaching all these different churches.
His father and his dad is an excellent man. He would never disrespect his wife like this.
Girl, I'm not talking about Mr. Cannon, okay? Let's talk about his father. Who? Same. It's just that when y'all first got together, I just knew that he was no good, but, you know
how it is. No, listen, both of y'all, listen. This is just too much for me right now. I mean, I just want to crawl in a hole and just sleep. Mama.
Yes.
Mama.
What?
Where is he? Yes. Where is Daddy, Mama?
Well.
But I will tell you this, that your daddy is pissed to high hell. I had to tell him to stay at home with me if he asked my daddy to go, because I didn't want him coming over here stressing you out. I'll tell him, this right here is not the time for your daddy to come over here, because he's so mad that the very picture of that boy could make your father snap. Anyway. I'm telling you, I have tried everything that I know how to do with that boy. And Lord knows I have tried to love the hell out of him. But not no more. I'm not doing it. I'm done. I just can't do it no more. And you know what else? I got good mind to go right on over to his little church on Sunday morning.
The Bible says that whatsoever a man soweth, he shall reap. And then he gon' reap.
I miss me, y'all. I appreciate y'all being here. But look, the best thing y'all can do for me is just pray for me. Just pray, because I'm just too weak right now. I'm too weak.
Listen, sweetie. I know that you are hurting, and I know that this is hard, but this too shall pass, man. And what I need you to always know is that God didn't bring you this far to fail.
Yeah.
And just because that man failed you does not mean that God is going to fail you. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? Now, me and the angel are here because we love you, and you have just got to remember the word that God's strength is made perfect in your weakness. Now, I'm going to be honest with you, baby. As much as I cannot stand Jeremy right now, I don't believe that this marriage is over. I mean, problems, baby. I mean, look at me and your father. Your father has not always been the man that he is today. Your dad. Yes, ma'am. Before I found out I was pregnant with you, your father and I separated. Yes. And I was a good woman as you, but believe it or not, I used to have an attitude. And your father had a pleasure with another woman. Somebody that would listen to him, pay attention to him. But I had to humble myself. Because it's always two sides to everything. And I had to look at myself and I prayed. And I asked God to change me. And he did. And when your father saw that I was changing, he came back home. Now, Mimi, I know that our situations are very different. And Lord knows that Jerry is nothing. And I mean nothing. But you know what I do know? It's not what you say. Because you're my baby. And I want to love him. So if you decide to fight for your marriage, we are going to fight with you.
See, Mama Victory, I was with you till you said that. Okay? I just feel like you need to just drop kick that winner and get caught with him. Okay, she's right. We will fight with you.
Yes, we will fight.
I mean, but what do you expect from me to do? I mean, he's already talked to an attorney. The divorce papers are right here.
But that doesn't mean you have to settle.
Come on, seriously, I don't have any more fight left in me.
Maybe that's a good place to be. Look, when you are feeling weak and broken, that's when you find God's strength. I mean, a lot of times, God can't do what he wants to do in our lives because we're too busy getting away with everything. Now, this right here, what you're going through, maybe, this is too big for you. You can't fight this on your own. No, ma'am. This is not a battle against flesh and blood. No, ma'am. No, ma'am. This right here, this is a spiritual attack. And I'm telling you, I have watched the devil over the years be very deceptive and intentional with his attacks against people's marriages. But what you have got to do is stand on the word of God. Pray over your husband. Honey, you got to fight this battle down on your knees. The Bible says for the members of our warfare are mighty through God for pulling down strongholds. So you can't afford to look at what you think it looks like or focus on what you think you see through your physical eye. You got to look at this thing through the lens of the Spirit. Now, you said that God's doing this together. Well, the Bible says that what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Now, that's Bible.
Look, Mimi, your mom, she's right. This battle right here, this is God's battle. Listen, Miss Green. Don't keep stressing about this. Don't lose no sleep. Just put it in God's hands, because he got you.
Now listen here, Mimi. We're about to go. But what I need you to understand is that you got to hold on. Everything is going to be all right. No matter how rough it gets, you better hold on. Hold on. Just a little while.
Go ahead. be right back.
First lady, I just want you to know that I'm here for you.
and that I'm praying for you, and that I care for you, and if it's anything.
I appreciate your prayers, I really do. But please, pray for my husband, because this is not the man that I married. The man that I know would never do this to me.
Yeah. I'm pressing now. But I want you to know that my only concern is for you. You see, First Lady, I just want you to know that what you mean to me. And I've watched you for years. And I always told myself that if I could ever get the chance to love you, girl, I'm gonna love you.
Love.
I wouldn't say that, you know. I read this book one time, and it helped me get through a season in my life.
Oh, okay. I might just give it a try then, Dick.
Let me ask you another question.
Yes.
Are you going to sign those papers?
I don't know. I'm still praying about it.
Well, I know I've said to see you, whether you choose to stay or you choose to go. But I always told myself that I would love you. But if you choose to fight, then I recommend that you read.
If she hadn't been so busy, I wouldn't have an opportunity to know you the way that I do.
This is true, you know. But one thing about it, sweetie, you never, don't get it mistaken, because you never have to worry about me working as much as like that. I plan on being up under you all the time.
All the time? Like all the time?
Yes, baby. All the time. See, I know what kind of man you are. I know that if I was able to get you from her, then if I come off my game, somebody might snag you from me. This chick ain't having that. That's why I stay cute in the face and slim in the waist.
Well, okay, you know, all of that sounds good and everything, but I'm just saying, there's gonna be some times where you can't be with me like all the time. There's gonna be times I'm gonna have to go out and do my ministry without you. I mean, I might have to go to the bathroom without you.
That's so funny. That is so cute. I mean, see, I like my man up under me. That's why we are perfect for each other. Baby, I am your personal assistant, your armor bearer, your driver, everything you need me to be, I'm capable of being. You never ever need anyone else to do anything for you, and you never have to worry about me working as much as Lady. And when she was so busy working and taking care of home that she missed out on taking care of the most important person.
Who that is?
Her husband. So she just slipped up and gave me the opportunity to slide right in and show you that I can love you a lot better. So baby, you better suck it up, because you are stuck with me.
Well, I tell you one thing.
You keep doing that thing you did with your mouth last time.
Love it. Well, I ain't going nowhere anyway. Love. That right there, that was everything.
Everything?
Look, I could never get Lady to do anything like that. She was so much more, what'd you say, conservative with her sex life, you know what I mean?
Well, baby, like that, I have a few more tricks up my sleeve that you know nothing about.
Girl, wait a minute, hold on now. Look, I done told you now. I am not going to sleep with you until those papers are signed. But I will tell you one thing. Once those papers are signed, sealed, delivered, baby, that will be the most amazing, the most wonderful 5 minutes of your life.
For her to sign.
Well, she ain't signed.
Okay, well,
sure it's not a big deal. Calm down.
No big deal?
Yeah.
Are you serious? No big deal? Well, I'm sitting here doing everything I can to take care of you while she's out doing her awful thing. You talking about no big deal? You told me she was gonna sign.
It's not what I said.
You better get her to sign these papers, because if you don't, we are gonna have some real issues here.
Look, kid. There's nothing, and I mean nothing, more unattractive than a jealous woman, especially a woman who's jealous of another man's wife. I'm just saying. Don't look at me like that, because you already knew before you even stepped to me that I was mad. Now, as far as these divorce papers are concerned, honestly, this is none of your business. But if you can't trust me, it ain't gonna work anymore.
Did you just say trust?
Yeah.
Trust? Jeremy, that's a word that you know nothing about. You want me to trust you, but you get up in the pulpit every Sunday preaching none of us sitting right there as a side chick. Because he gave it for himself. Then you talk about if a man don't take care of his household, he's worse than an infidel. And you want me to trust you? Trust is something you know nothing about. Now look, I may not be the sharpest chick on the block.
As long as you keep working them jobs the way you do, I ain't going nowhere, okay? Now listen, she will sign the papers. Trust me, okay?
Sure.
Yes.
Don't
play
with me.
I'm not gonna kill you. Come on.
Okay.
You look like a, I'm gonna walk you out of. Let me go get the rest of my stuff.
You know I have a nail appointment, hurry up.
Yes, but Why are you being so nice?
When I pulled up in the yard and I saw your car out front, I wanted to run in here and slap you and punch you and kick you and cuss you out. But when I walked in my house and I saw Kizzy, I realized you had everything you needed, honey. But sooner or later, you're gonna realize, listen, Jeremy, you're gonna realize that I was more woman than you ever deserved.
But, Kizzy is all the woman I need.
No, I know. You're right. She's exactly what you do. So, get her and those 20 people living in her head. And then fine, I promise you, this Jeremy, you need to be more concerned about.
What you mean?
Listen, Ted, now you remember the late Mother Lucy and how she used to always after church to pray for her granddaughter who was like in and out of the hospital a lot?
Yeah, she said something like she would be having a bad relationship and every time they have a breakup, she had a sick spell.
That's it. The sick spells for her is different from sick spells for us.
I mean, she'd be in the hospital though, right?
Did you ever go see her in the hospital?
No.
Well, let's just say this. She could only have visitors between certain hours, and she wasn't in any intensive or critical care unit.
Oh, my kid!
You get it? Hickory dickory dock. There's always someone who has a genuine heart and compassion for you. You can't let that encounter completely distorts your perception of everybody. Everybody ain't bad.
Well, you know you're right. Deacon Smith is a wonderful man. But, I think he has other reasons for checking on you.
Girl, what are you talking about?
Girl, you ain't foolish and you ain't blind. That man, he wants you.
Girl, he doesn't want me. He checks on everybody. Stop. And plus, I'm married.
And soon to be divorced.
Oh, man, I'm not one to trust in God to save my marriage.
You know what? You're right. I'm sorry. But if he doesn't, I sure pray that he saves Deacon Smith. Because, oh, Jesus! That man is fine.
Breathtaking.
Oh, striking.
Definitely. Yeah.
God's gift to humanity.
A breath of fresh air.
Oh, hallelujah!
Jesus.
Because I promise you, if she's not able to save your divorce, she'll definitely help you, you know, recover.
Yeah, I mean, Deacon Smith said it was a good book. So,
see?
Yeah, I'll give it a try.
Okay, well, we get out of here. What about the pregnancy test, though?
Girl, I'm not pregnant. I mean, if I get sick again, I'll take one then. But for now, I'm good.
Okay, well, let me know if you need anything, okay?
Thank you so much.
All right.
Betrayed me. left me feeling so empty. Now I'm trying hard to find me. I'm trying hard. Maybe not for me. Some man alone
left me,
and I'm trying hard to breathe. Still believe
in love,
and it's unconditionally. Not the kind that runs away, but the kind that comes and stays.
I still believe.
Not the kind that runs away, but the kind that comes and stays.
I still believe.
Oh, but the time that comes and stays,
I still
anything I can.
Please. Thank you. Look, it's like I told you before, first thing. Whether you choose to stay or you choose to fight, I know that either way, you need time to heal. But I always told myself that if I could ever girl, I would love you forever.
Pastor has stopped nurturing me. I can't tell you the last time that he's cradled me in his arms. So, I really appreciate you being here right now.
You know, First Lady, if you would let me be here, I would be here every day.
You're so silly.
You see, First Lady, I love you. I love everything there is about you. Like the way you wave your head. Soft sway in your gentle touch. But you know what I really love? The way you demand attention when you walk up in the church. I'm talking about, I love your sweet smelling hair. I love those beautiful eyes. I love your beautiful smile. You know, First Lady, you are so different and so unique. But what I really love is the way you minister and you console the hurting and those who are in need. Your intellect is so captivating to me. I love you then. I love you now. And I will love you.
Yeah. Oh, wow. I've never been spoken.
Just call me Mitchell.
Mitchell, I don't know what to say.
It's not anything to say. Let's just enjoy this moment that we have together.
Right there.
And if we end up together, I don't want anything to interfere with it. But you gotta go right now.
Give us clarity to the questions that we have through your word, Lord God. And Lord God, I ask that you would just give Mimi peace, Lord God. In Christ's name we pray, amen.
Amen.
You're welcome. So, tell me about yourself.
Well, I'm 32, so I am an executive at my company.
Okay.
I'm married to Jeremy. Uh-huh. We don't have any children.
Oh,
let's see. I love music.
Mm-hmm.
And I love taking care of my mom.
Okay, alright. So aside from music, what else do you love to do?
I love going to church.
Oh, wow. I like you're living. So, anything else? So let me just make sure that I'm understanding you correctly. You enjoy music, you go to work, you come home and you take care of your home, and you think you're taking care of your husband, and you go to church because you feel obligated? Does that sound about right?
Wait, where are you going with this? I mean, I take very good care of my husband. I've devoted every bit of energy I have
happened to that man in his ministry? Now, wait a minute. If I sound a little offended, because I am.
Listen, I'm not trying to offend you at all. You know, I'm not here to decide whether or not you are a great and loving and supportive wife, because I'm sure you are. But what I'm trying to show to you is that while you have spent so much time and energy investing in the man and the church, you've done neither one of them any injustice because you've neglected yourself. Listen, self-love means that you take time and you take care of you. You make sure that the things and the people that you are putting attention into are reaping dividends to you. I'm not saying it's not okay to take care of your husband, but what I'm saying is you make sure that it is a mutually beneficial relationship. Listen, when you love yourself the right way, you set guidelines for how you're willing to accept love for other people, and you give love differently. Listen, self-love means that you force people that are in your life to love you with the respect that you deserve. And if they don't, you give them the opportunity to either get better or walk out. Listen, it's painful at first. It really is. Letting people go, whether it's friends or relationships, is not easy. But I promise you, when you do, it will reap dividends.
I understand what you're saying. Sounds like you're saying I need to get to a point to where I love me enough that I don't accept any kind of inconsistent love.
Exactly. And you do that when you understand how God feels about you and how much He loves you and cares about you. When you begin to love yourself better, your whole life will change. Listen, honey, I know exactly how you feel. You see, several years ago, I lost a man that I thought I was going to spend the rest of my life with. And going through that divorce, I took time and I asked God, what could I have done better in the relationship? And you know the word of God declares that God will not have any other gods before Him. You know what? When the rubber met the road and I sat down and I began to analyze everything I went through, I realized I had made that man my God. I was paying the bills and I was doing crazy things to keep a relationship, and God wasn't pleased. But listen, I'm so glad that God always calls us to triumph. You know, Romans 8 and 28 says that all things work together for the good to them that love God and are called according to His purpose. And I believe I'm called according to His purpose. And so now God has sent a wonderful man into my life. And this man loves me the right way, and it's a healthy type of love. And you know what, Mimi? That's the kind of love I desire for you. I want your marriage to not just survive, but thrive.
But you know what, Tiffany? I don't even think I want it, babe.
I can understand that. Listen, that's going to be between you and God. But whether you choose to stay with Him or go on to another relationship, you have first got to learn how to love you. And you need to understand that you are enough, honey.
Where do I start?
Well, since you asked, you can start by fixing yourself up a little bit.
Stuff like this.
And that just might be the problem. That man puts the I in five.
Well, he must be some type of man.
Mm-hmm, he is, and he's single too. Oh. Now, you know, he's a little too much for me because he's all into the church thing, but he may be good for you.
Well, I just happen to have a wonderful man in my life, so I'm good, but thank you.
BD Asia, stop trying to play matchmaker. She already has a man. Plus, you know, Deacon Smith probably isn't her type anyway.
Huh. I didn't know any better, Mimi. I would think that she was feeling Deacon.
Honey, no, I am married.
Well, separate it.
Well, okay, ladies, I'm gonna get going, but don't forget your assignments.
Okay.
Well, what assignment? You know, I gotta keep check on her because she tends to be stubborn sometimes.
Well, Deasia, I would love to tell you, but I can't discuss my sessions with other people. She would have to tell you.
Mimi?
Where's Deasia?
What assignment?
All she said was, I need to start focusing on myself and maybe fix myself up just a little bit.
Girl, if that's what she said, I could have been a counselor if that's what it took.
Wait.
I'm just saying, Mimi, you know, you are really beautiful, and you know, I feel like you can be a little attractive, too, if you pick yourself up.
But pastor wives have to be conservative.
Who taught you that? Girl, that definitely the guy she married to.
Oh, Lord.
I was told that the one of the thought had to marry you that third man.
Girl, please. Listen, you can be beautiful and classy and still look good. Listen, you hear God, right?
Yes.
You know the voice of God, right?
Right.
So if God is not condemning you, neither should we. Just saying.
But all I have is stuff like this, y'all.
Well, I guess you know what that means. Shopping! And girl, let me tell you, I know about these two boutiques called Style Haven and Fancy. We gotta try them out.
Well, you girls have fun. I'm actually gonna be rocking Epi Couture, and when you get ready for a personal stylist, you should try her out. But anyway, listen, this weekend I'm gonna be speaking on a freedom celebration, and it's a black and white event. And I would love for you all to come. If you're interested, I can have Reese pick you up and he'll have the tickets.
Oh,
but hold on a minute. You saying Reese? Like that's your driver?
No.
White hope girl is fancy.
No, sweetheart, Reese is my man, so don't be trying no funny business. Ladies, enjoy yourself. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you too.
Oh, girl, I'm excited. And maybe we can go by tea salon. You know, have a new little something to your
hands. Well, let me grab her first.
All right.
What are you doing?
Thank you.
Selfish,
yeah.
I'm ignorant, you know. Yeah. I was just too stubborn to see those things, man. But look, not only have I now probably lost the woman that I vowed to love and to protect for the remainder of my life, I'm also about to lose my best friend in the process, man. Look, MJ, dude, we're gonna wait back, bro. I'm sorry, man. Can you please forgive me?
Oh, that was so sweet.
Look, man. I forgive you, but I ain't trying to hear this crazy thing that you all of a sudden had this deep epiphany of what good marriage you had and how you lost your marriage and your friend because of your stupid, effed up ways.
Because of
okay.
All right.
So, right. just to let you know, I forgive you, but I ain't buying socks.
Man, come on, man. Look, come on, help me out.
Come on, MJ. I believe it was being sincere.
Thank you.
Sincere. Yeah, right.
Come on.
Man, this is the exact thing I expect from Jeremy. Matter of fact, the only reason why he's sorry is because the results he intended didn't come out like he intended. Like I said, I forgive you, but I ain't buying the issue. Matter of fact, I guarantee you, kids is psycho crazy, but she didn't show him her other personality.
Is he right?
Man, Bobby, come on, man, let's get out of here, man. Look, Jeremy, I thank you for your apology, but I made up my mind, I want real, true friends in my life. You know what I'm saying? You know, I can say that I'm not perfect. So I need people in my life that's gonna tell me when I've done something wrong. And I need to be able to do the same thing to them. No, just hear me out, man. Just hear me out. See, I don't hate women.
I don't hate women.
Hold up. My mother, she's a good woman. So is my grandmother, my aunt, my sisters, and a whole bunch of other women I know.
Man, I cherish them. And one day, I just pray to God that one day he sent me the woman of my dream.
Me too.
But see, you had you had a beautiful queen. You had a beautiful queen and you broke her. You sucked all the life out of her and left her for some fairy tale. And when your boy, your friend, your ace tried to help you through this God-awful experience that you're having, you got mad. So, as a friend, and because I love you, I'm gonna tell you like this. Man, you in trouble? But I'm gonna tell you like this, man. God is not mocked. Maybe you heard this before. God is not mocked. Whatsoever man soweth, that shall he also reap. But until then, I'm about
to give you a nice
mic.
Kids, listen. I have been praying, and I have been talking to God, and I am repenting, okay? I want my marriage back. I'm sorry, Kiki, but it's over.
I need to speak with Jeremy. We got to have a serious talk.
I mean, Mimi, what else would you have to say to him? I mean, unless it's get out with your soft shit.
Wait, listen. I appreciate you, Bestie. I do. I enjoy going to South Haven and Fancy. But look, I'll see you tomorrow, okay? Thank you so much. Smoochie. Call me.
Mimi. You are so beautiful. Look at you. You are so gorgeous. Look, let me talk to you for a second. Baby, I love you so much. I know I've not been the best man for you. I know that I've taken advantage of you. I know that I took advantage of your kindness and your tender heart. Baby, I know that I don't even deserve a second chance. Baby, I don't even deserve to be in your presence right now. You know? But, baby, I know that you are a forgiving woman. And you have a heart of gold. And you work with everything that you got, and you do so unconditionally. Baby, it took me a while to see that. I see this now. Listen, if you will give me one more chance, I promise I will be the man that I told you I would be when I asked you to marry me. Baby, listen, if you will give me one more chance, I will be the man that I said I would be the day. This is before God said our vows. I will honor you in your presence and in your absence. It took me a while to get here, but I'm here. And listen, I'm here. I'm here right now. And listen, look at me. My eyes are wide open. And if you will give me one more chance, trust me, one more time, you will never have to worry about where I've been, where I'm going, who I'm with. Mimi, I promise you, I will give you my life. If you would just give me back your heart. Jamie, I promise you, I'm so serious. I mean it right now when I said it. Baby, I want us. Baby, I want us for you.
Jerry. Me too. I waited years to hear you say those words to me. I even dreamt of a moment when you would come to your senses and become the man that you promised me you would be.
Yes.
I even imagined what I would say to you, how I would hug you and I would kiss you. And I would say, oh my God, baby, I'm glad you
We made it.
We finally here.
Yes. We did.
We're here. But strangely enough, your confession didn't move me one bit. See, while I'm out there doing your own thing, I had time to find me. And discover me. And I realized I had given you way too much space in my life and too much power. You are absolutely right when you say that I'm a forgiving woman and that I have a good heart. But I vowed to myself that I would never ever discount myself to someone who can't even afford to stand in my place. Accept your apologies, and I'm going to forgive you, but I
can't be with you.
Walk out and just leave me in here to just try to figure this thing out on my own? Well, Mimi, you just said that you love me.
There was a point where I loved you more than I loved my very breath. But then you left. And in just a few days, I rediscovered what it's like to love me. Now wait. Now I wish you nothing but the best in your life and in your ministry. My Jimmy.
Come on, girl.
Let him back in. See, that's why I knew I shouldn't have left you here with him last night. Mimi, you're just too weak for his smooth talk.
No, girl, it wasn't nothing like that. I mean, he would have had to sleep in his car, and I couldn't have that, so.
What?
I actually gave him the divorce papers.
What do you mean you couldn't have that? Mimi, do you hear you? This man had dragged your name through the mud, took you down Skid Row, and back, and had this trick all up through your house. And you mean to tell me that you're concerned? We have sleeping in a lavish car with some fine leather? Girl, please.
Deandre, you would never understand, so let's just move past this.
Okay, you're right. We have a ball to attend, so let's go get you made over. Meet Prince Charming.
Hey.
And our ride should be here at 5:30, so we don't have time.
Hey, ladies, how are y'all? Good. Thank you.
Hello, ladies.
Hey, you.
The agent. What you all dressed up for?
As if it's any of your business. Me and Mimi are going to a ball.
Okay. I see y'all, Cinderella and stuff, going to the ball and everything. You look all nice. I see you. That's nice.
You feeling okay?
Yes, I am. Why?
Because you mean all nice, and I don't know whether to take it as a compliment or to run.
Listen, the agent, I've been praying to God, and I've repented, and I've asked him to work on me, to make me a better man. Believe it or not, he's doing it. He's doing it from the inside out.
That's impressive.
Yeah. You had it. Don't you know what I'm saying? Y'all expect to come
back? I'll y'all out.
Oh, what's going on, Deacon Smith? Oh, Deacon, what's going on, man? Hey, what brings you by?
I come by to check on the ladies. I'm gonna trail them to the ball tonight.
I don't think they need any adult supervision.
Well, actually, Deacon Smith, he is always invited.
Okay, well then, let me go get dressed in.
No, Jeremy, no. Sorry. It's a ticketed event, and the tickets all sold out, so you're going to have to miss it.
What is going on over here? Hello.
How you doing, man? I'm looking for a beautiful lady by the name of Mimi.
how can I help you, sir?
So I've been tasked with making sure they make it to the ball safely tonight.
See, now that right there, now that's a lot. I know y'all must think I'm crazy if you think two men just gonna show up my house to escort y'all to some ball. All right, now this sound like y'all doing some type of triple dating stuff. The agent, it sound like he got your name all over it.
Jeremy,
I
thought you changed.
I did change, but this right here, come on now. I don't know about this. You got Lee Smith in there. He got a David Paul. Thank you. Appreciate you. Y'all can leave.
You guys are ladies ready to go?
Yes, we are.
Wait a minute. Oh, watch your hand. So y'all just gonna leave? That's how y'all feel?
Bye, Jeremy.
Everybody, wait, so y'all all messed up, y'all just gonna leave me? Is that how we feel? Wait, hold on. Oh, okay. So, that's how we do? You acting up? Okay. Alright. That's fine. Mama Victory.
Dear, who's this?
Mama, this is Jeremy.
Jeremy?
Yes. Listen, Mom, I really need to talk to you. I think something's wrong with Mimi.
Oh, what do you need to talk for?
Can you guys come over and talk? I just need to talk to you, please.
What's wrong with Mimi?
Just can you come over, please, so I can talk to you?
Okay. All right. Okay.
Bye. Ooh, God, Lord, please do not let me lose that beautiful woman.
Yeah.
She's pregnant.
God, I prayed for a baby and you answered my prayers? I came over the other day and I was begging her and asking her to forgive me and to take me back, but she said no and she handed me the divorce papers. So today I walk into the house and her and De'Asia are getting all dolled up and talking about they going to some ball or something like that, and while she in the back getting dressed, Deacon Smith and some other dude come over and talk about they gonna them to the ball or something like that. And so I was just like, all right, well, if they come to the ball, I'm going to the ball. And the agent won't get up talking about, nah, it's a ticket, it's a bit. You can't come. Nah, you can't come. And you know how the agent be acting, because the agent don't really like me. But it really sounds like the agent trying to set her up with somebody, man. You know, I know it's not Deacon Smith, though, because you know how she feels about Deacon Smith. Probably that other dude. But my point is, I really just don't understand what's going on. Why won't Mimi give me another chance? I mean, I prayed and I asked God to restore my marriage, but I don't see anything happening.
Really, Jeremy?
Yes.
Well, it sounds to me like you're just reaping what you sow. I mean, and the crazy thing is that we all know that Mimi is a very open girl, and she never hides anything from me. So, yes, I knew she was going to the ball. And yes, I knew that the two gentlemen were coming over to meet her and De'Asia. She doesn't hide anything
from me. Okay, well listen. Did she tell you about this?
No. Not initially.
Okay.
But when I told her what God had shown me, she confirmed it. And Let's be real here, Jeremy. You got a whole lot of reaping to do, son. I mean, the thing about it is, what you're feeling is probably guilt from all the crap that you done put Mimi through. Now you know good and doggone well that Mimi would never cheat on you. And you certainly know that she would never open one door without closing the other one. Now, I'm her mother, and I'm proud of her. So whatever decision she makes, I support her 100%. So if she decides to stay in this marriage or not, I support her. And
concerned with is trying to be a better man so that you can help her raise this boy or girl that you're going to have and raise him to be a decent adult.
Mama, that's exactly what I'm talking about, though. I can't take the chance of her possibly ending up with somebody else and that person raising my child.
Really?
Yes.
Son, you worried about the wrong thing. Why don't you pray and ask God for His will to be done in this situation? Then all you have to do is sit back and watch God work, preacher.
Listen, I've been telling you this for quite some time. You know, my wife and I try to stay out of your marriage.
Mm-hmm.
But I've sit back and I've watched you hurt, disrespect my daughter time and time again. Looks like you ran out of time sometimes. I mean, we try to treat you like a son of our own, but you made us a real challenge. It's crazy because you say you want God to change you. And you say you want God to fix your marriage. Well, I believe He can and that He will, but first and foremost, you've got to be sincere. And once you become sincere, you got to come forth and repent for everything that you've done. Oh my God, I know where you've been, and I know I'm not the one on trial here. But my testimony is that He did it for me. I know for a fact that He can do it for you. But first and foremost, you gotta be godly sorrow. See, God wants us to have truth from the inside that shows up on the outside. And when you walk in the Word of God. Jerry, listen. I don't know if you know, but I've been where you're sitting right now. I've been in that seat. You gotta understand, I believe that God can and God will. Watch this. The Word says, in Galatians 6 and 1, that because y'all are be overtaken in a fall, we which are spiritual, this is all such a kind of spirit.
Say it to me.
Now, I ain't coming to preach to you, but God can restore you. God can restore your marriage. And not only that, if you allow Him to come into your life, He'll line everything up the way it's supposed to be. You just gotta get that to Him.
I want Him to come in and make me a better me. I can't go out here and preach the gospel and not live the same thing that I'm preaching.
All right.
I can't go out here and win souls for Christ and then lose my own. I need God in my life. I need Him to change me. You know what? Pops. Can you do me a favor? Can you please lead me in a sinner's prayer? I need God.
Wait.
Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I confess that I'm a sinner.
I confess that I'm a sinner.
In need of a Savior.
In need of a Savior.
Lord, I ask you to forgive me of my sins.
Lord, I ask you to please me
beings. Though they are me, though they are me. I believe that you died.
You believe that you died?
Was buried.
Was buried.
And was resurrected for my sin.
And was resurrected for my sin.
And by faith.
And by faith.
I believe it.
I believe it.
That I am saved.
That I am saved.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
We pray.
Pray.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
You love me, son. I mean, we love you. And we really want this marriage to work. Now, God can do this. Now, he may do it quicker, or it could take a long time. And what you've got to do is trust in me.
Okay. I will. I promise. Cash down.
Mom, Dad, what are y'all doing here? What are y'all doing here?
Hey. I'm gonna ask us to come in very long.
Yeah.
looks like you're having
a time.
Yes, this is. This is Reese, Tiffany Lamia's friend.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, you're my friend.
Boy, I'll have to tell you what I was thinking. Oh, boy, you don't know what I was thinking.
Yes, we are, and with the baby coming, we decided to give love one more chance.
Oh my gosh, a baby! Congratulations, thank you! Oh my God, that's so awesome!
Phyllis, thing is, out of everything that I've done, God still found favor in me, and outside of me receiving what I should have received, he decided to bless us. Instead, I have a praying wife, a forgiving wife, and she loves me and I love her. We're gonna make this thing happen.
That's so beautiful. You know what? God's grace is so amazing. I mean, it's so amazing that he doesn't give us what we deserve. I'm telling you, this is such a blessing. I'm so happy for you.
You know she's right, guys. If I may add, I've been favored so much. Sometimes God is trying to give us something, but we always find ourselves running.
Bro, let me tell you. I've been running this whole plate. But I'm excited to stand out of the way and let him do his thing.
No doubt, man. If you don't mind, though, you know, I think I need to stand out my own way.
Oh, okay, buddy. Do you got it?
Excuse me, baby. I've been fighting and running from these feelings for a long time.
Uh-oh.